My name is Tom Walder. I'm a senior director in the chemistry R&D group, where I've been for 32 years now. We were just coming off the launch of Xterra columns, and we were looking at what we could do next in this area of hybrid particles. And we became very intrigued by looking at the structure of the organic group we were building into the particles. With Xterra, we had a methyl group built into a siloxane network, but we realized those groups actually terminated the network. So we were not able to make particles that were as strong as we wanted to. When we incorporated a bridged ethyl group that now bridged across two silicon atoms, now we could get particles that were very, very stable mechanically. And these very rugged, mechanically stable particles that we called BEH really enabled the development of ultra-performance liquid chromatography, which was a whole new level of performance in the HPLC world. And these particles enabled us to pack columns that could withstand these much higher pressures, much harsher conditions. The most distinguishing characteristics of the BEH particles as compared to Xterra is, again, their ruggedness, their ability to withstand not only higher pressures, but also a wider range of pHs. So the ability to withstand high pH mobile phases is an order of magnitude better than it is for Xterra. High pH is important in chromatography because there are a lot of types of analytes that prefer to be separated at higher pH because they're not stable at lower pH, or because of their ionization characteristics, they just give better separations at higher pH. There are a lot of other materials that chromatographers have used for doing high pH separations. There are materials like zirconia, even carbon. The challenge with those kind of materials is the surface chemistry is very different. So a chromatographer who has already tried to use C18 silica columns, and now they grab one of these zirconia or carbon-based columns, it's a much bigger challenge to optimize the separation. They have to learn all the rules about how to optimize with these different materials. The beauty of BEH is it's very similar to silica chemically. So somebody who's familiar with using a silica-based column can very easily swap in a BEH column and get good performance right from the beginning. One important direction after we completed the development of the BEH columns was to look at how do charged compounds behave, particularly under mass spec compatible mobile phase conditions. Things like formic acid in the mobile phase becomes very popular when you're using mass spectrometry detection. And for basic compounds in particular, BEH columns, when used with those mobile phases, they leave some room for improvements. So we were very focused on how could we improve that performance, particularly for basic compounds with formic acid.